Well, the SkillBridge application that I rebuilt in my PDI just to get more practice with building applications out. The intent of this fictional project was really just to build a centralized system to apply, approve, reject, and track SkillBridge applications across all the different components. So for the build out, I'll show you a few different things that I used, starting with Studio. Studio was used to build out the application, the modules, the tables, the forms, the roles, access controls, and you can see everything that was built out is contained here. Then moving on to the ServiceNow platform itself, this is where I built out some different reports, the groups, the users, the dashboard that you see, and a record producer as well. So nice thing about things like the dashboard is it's different reports that are set up. So I could see like how many cases by branch, the duration, how long individuals typically request, and which companies they're using the most. So different information to track. So nice view. I can click on any of these to drill down to see those actual tasks. And I could open it further and just see all the different information for the particular request. So this request is still open. It's for Michael Bolton to work at Dunder Mifflin. If I click on all, I could see all the different tasks that are here. Then a record producer was built in here as well. And I'll show you this in a second from the user view, but ultimately this is a nice, easy way for our users to use to answer their questions and provide the information that we need. Okay, for the automation, the different flows in Flow Designer. So you'll see this particular one, starts with a trigger with a new SkillBridge request from the service catalog, and then it goes on the path saying like what to do with that particular request. If they approve it, what happens? If they reject it, what happens? What if this errors out? Then it's going to create a task for the ServiceNow team to then go in and fix. So the flows, I'm still working, learn, and get more practice in these, but these are great for automation and email notifications and just doing a lot of that, automating a lot of the work that you would typically do manually if you weren't working in ServiceNow. And then on to the service portal. So this is the user-friendly page that they'll access. So this is the application button. Different information if you click on these links, it'll take you to. And I'm logged in as an admin, so I could see all the different reports. I like to see those as an admin. So clicking on the record producer. So regardless of who's logged in, you'd be able to go in here and submit application. So I'm able to submit application for a different user, answer the questions that I need, how long is it for, which company, and upload my MOU, and then click submit. And then I can go into, so I'm an admin. If I look at my requests, I could see, so this was actually from the workflow, one of the SkillBridge requests that was submitted, that flow aired out. So that created this, that generated this ticket that went to me for me to fix the flow and Flow Designer. So this was just a quick walkthrough. Just wanted to share, again, so much to learn. I'm still learning. It's a lot of fun. There's so much to it, but just wanted to share what I had thus far. Thank you.